Now, live from the Super Doppler 10 Weather Center, this is a severe weather alert.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm meteorologist Jeremy Wheeler, and I'm here at Wavy TV Studios, and we've got hit by Hurricane Matthew. Now, when I say that, it was hit from a distance because Matthew is to the south of our region. It is to our south. But still, all the heavy rain, all the wind moved north of the hurricane. So there it is. Here's our viewer photos, some of the examples of what's going on out there right now. You've got, this is from Luis Munoz, the hilltop area apartments. We've got flooding. It's up to the vehicle wheel wells. My vehicle was affected out here, Wavy TV Studios. I parked in a spot that usually doesn't flood even during a hurricane. But we had so much heavy rain that we're street flooding in areas that don't flood. And so my vehicle was also affected. This is Tamika Kemp's Lake, Virginia Beach. It was more than an hour ago. This was posted a while ago, but lots of water standing out there. This is Front Yard and Levi, and lost one vehicle. You know, can't afford another loss, but you know, we got hit hard, and there was more rain than forecast. Now, here's the latest with Matthew. It's post-tropical, it's non-tropical now. 75 mile an hour winds, moving east northeast at 14 miles an hour. There's your pressure. Now, it is going to move away from us today, and it will lose some of the strength. And so the farther away it gets us into Monday, the better our weather is going to get. Even by later this afternoon, our conditions are really going to improve. Doesn't look like it's going to curve back to the south now, at least in the official forecast, but it may do so as we get later into the week. Now, we have flash flood warnings in effect for mainland Dare County and Outer Banks Dare, and also for areas like Plymouth, North Carolina, and south of Bertie County. Those are flash flood warnings, meaning that the water came up really fast. We had flash flood warnings earlier for our region, but now it's just a flood warning. It's just a difference of timing, basically. And so we've got flood warnings up till 7:45 a.m. for this whole region. So that's for the Eastern Shore. That is for the peninsula, Hampton, Pocosin, Newport News, York County. And then for the south side, Norfolk, Virginia Beach, Chesapeake, Portsmouth, Suffolk, Isle of Wight, in towards Franklin, in towards Southampton County, all in northeast North Carolina, from Currituck County all the way back to Northampton County, and including Bertie County. This is till 7:45 a.m. Lots of flooding happening out there right now. Super Doppler 10. Again, the center is to the south of Hatteras. Matthew is to the south of Hatteras, but it threw so much heavy rain northward. That's why we had the flooding. It ran into a cold front and a stationary front, and that squeezed out a lot of the moisture. So right now it is more of a light to moderate rain across the Outer Banks. It's wind driven, so it feels a lot heavier, but right now it's mostly light to moderate from Corolla back to Ahoskie. That's good. Earlier we had some red colors and yellows. That's where it was a torrential downpour. Now it's down to these lighter greens and medium greens where it's light to moderate. That's the case for Virginia Beach, Chesapeake, Norfolk, Portsmouth, Suffolk, Newport News, and Hampton, and over into Smithfield, into Franklin, into Wakefield. And again, it's mostly a light to moderate rain, but it is wind driven, so it's going to feel pretty heavy, especially outside your window, outside your door. Now we go into Gloucester County, light to moderate, Matthews County, Middlesex, Northern Neck, but it's heavier. This is moderate to almost heavy at times over on the Eastern Shore. It's lightened up in Cape Charles and Melville, but look at the yellow area that was here earlier. That's been moving off to the west. And so what will happen is, this is the forecast now, that rain will edge to the east. That heavy rain is going to be east of here. This model update, and I think it'll come more in line with my thinking. The back edge of the rain is already over towards the Sussex County. So this is at 7 a.m. Basically, you want to fast forward it, and this rain should push east a little bit quicker. We'll still have some showers, but it'll break up quite a bit. And so after 8 a.m., most of the rain is near the coast, and I'm hoping it's even off the coast by noontime already. Getting into the afternoon, there you go, sunshine. We're going to start drying things out. Unlike last time when we had all that heavy rain a couple weeks ago, afterwards we didn't have a lot of sunshine. It was a little breezy, but today we're going to have a dry wind. A lot drier is going to move in, and the sun is going to pop out there by the end of the day. That should help to dry things up. Sunday, 8 p.m., clearing skies, and then overnight, we're going to have some clearing in here as well. Through the day tomorrow, lots of sunshine expected, and again, that should work to dry things up. But it takes a while for this amount of water to go down. So our winds at the moment, they're out of the northeast, running at 25, 35 miles an hour. These are sustained winds. Virginia Beach, 38, Norfolk, 35, Hampton, 22. And there's the wind in Elizabeth City, north at 40, in Melpha, north at 21. And there's some of the gusts. So these are the peak winds. They peak up to 66 in Virginia Beach. That hasn't updated. I wonder if it just hadn't updated lately, but still, it is a strong wind. 55 miles an hour in Killable Hills, 29 miles an hour Wallops Island. Virginia Beach has had some extreme winds lately. stronger than forecast. Now here's the forecast going forward. This is our model, and it's calling for winds still about 25 to 35 miles an hour this morning, and then starting to wrap up as we get into the midday hours and the afternoon. Now they're out of the northwest. Still going to be breezy, but the strongest winds should die down. It has caused a lot of power outages across the area. And then here's overnight, winds will subside, and by tomorrow morning, we're dealing with some winds out of the north, maybe about 20 miles an hour, but much better. And by the end of the day, northwest, about 10 to 15. So that's what I'm expecting. Here's some other winds down along the coast, Manio and Hatteras, 40 miles an hour right now for the wind in Manio, 23 miles an hour in Hatteras, which is interesting because Hatteras is, of course, closer to the center of the storm. So those winds were able to stretch out. Now our winds are causing some tidal flooding, and we had street flooding. It's compounding the problem. This is in front of our building, Lake Wavy. The water came up to the building. Hadn't come in the building to my knowledge, but it got pretty close, and it did make it up into the parking lot. So the official number here, 5.8 feet. This is at Sewell's Point, 5.8 feet. That's moderate tidal flooding, but you add on the rain, and it might as well be major. So that might happen again this afternoon, 3:45 p.m. Sunday. And then Monday morning, it goes down to minor tidal flooding levels, so it does improve. Here's Fort Monroe. We've got some moderate tidal flooding in there for today for the forecast at 4 p.m., the next one, and then moderate again. Nuisance tidal flooding coming up later, but right now we've got some moderate, and then it should be minor at Yorktown later today, 4.4 feet, and I believe 4.5 is the cutoff for moderate on that one. Here's some other tides. Chesapeake Bay Bridge Tunnel, this is important, 5.9 feet. Virginia Beach, north end, you could see some major. It's just below major, but I put you in that category. Hopefully it comes down a little bit, but we still have strong winds, Chesapeake Bay Bridge Tunnel, so that is going to be a problem for us. Next one then, that's at 3 p.m. this afternoon, 3 a.m. tomorrow morning, 4.2 goes down to minor. Duck, North Carolina, major tidal flooding, 2 p.m. later today. The wind's strong along the coast, and then 6.1 feet Monday, 3 a.m., and then there's Kiptopeke on the eastern shore, 4.4 feet. That's moderate. It'll go down to minor by tomorrow. So these are the rain totals through midnight. So I'm going to change this. That's through midnight. We had so far 10.36 inches in Windsor, 9.26 Deep Creek, 9 inches at Langley, 5.75 at Langley, pardon me, and then 6.16 inches in Elizabeth City. So that was through midnight. And then this is since midnight, so I apologize for the confusion there, but basically you can add these numbers together to get some of the total. So we've had since midnight 1.58 inches, Hampton 2, 2.27 inches, Elizabeth City, and going forward we'll see maybe another inch, maybe up to two, but I think up to an inch is possible. Now today's forecast, we get showers this morning, windy conditions, winds out of the north at 20 to 30, gust of 50. They are going to come down though later this afternoon. They'll be running more in the like 15 to 25 mile an hour category and gusts up to about 35 to 40. High temps at least are in the 60s, so those that have lost power, at least we don't have to worry about the air conditioner not running, people getting overheated. So we got that going for us. So that is the forecast. Again, be safe out there. We got hit pretty hard by Matthew. Even though it was far from us, it sent the effects far north, all the way up to really to Washington, D.C., but here in Hampton Roads in northeast North Carolina, yeah, we took a big hit. And so when you wake up this morning, you might look out your window, and there's probably going to be quite a bit of flooding out there, street flooding and the like. So we're going to have updates going forward. We've got live crews coming up. Wavy News 10 at 6 a.m. We're going to have a full update, a full newscast, and we're going to have live reports from all over the area and give you the information you need to know. Just don't go out this morning. Be safe. It is dangerous out there. The heaviest rain has moved east, but there's still rain, and there's tidal flooding right now. So we're going to return you to programming for a little bit. We're going to get some more information on our reports, and we're going to display that information coming up again. Wavy News 10 at 6 a.m.